Hey, what's up everybody? Sleepy Ellis here. Thanks again for watching and welcome to my new subscribers. If you're new to my channel, I'm trying to bring you cryptocurrency news in an entertainment kind of way, so it's easy for you to digest. So today, I wanted to start off with the news that Blockstream has done a major achievement today. So they have performed the first transaction of Litecoin with SegWit on the Lightning Network. So the transaction went from Zurich to San Francisco and back instantly. So yeah, earlier this week I said, hey, but where can I spend my Litecoin? So I forgot about it, but of course Coinify, which is a point of sale service, is already providing Litecoin on their devices. So that means that 5,500 merchants can accept Litecoin. But if you put things into perspective, if you compare it with Bitcoin, that's nothing, of course, 5,500. So to give you a small example, here in the Netherlands, we have a city called Arnhem, aka Bitcoin City. And here, it's really being accepted for, you know, 114 merchants. So yeah, that's still a small amount. But that's 2% of the 5,500, right? And let's compare it with Japan, for instance. Japan itself has 5,500 merchants that are accepting that. But also there are collaborations with point of sales providers. And I've also touched base on that some weeks ago. And the forecast is that by this summer, 260,000 merchants will accept Bitcoin. So that brings us to the coins of coins, Bitcoin. At the moment, as a store of value, there's no doubt about it, Bitcoin is the coin for storing your value. But if you look at it as a practical currency, it's an issue, right? So at the moment we have 110,000 unconfirmed transactions, and I personally experienced it now in real life because I wanted to purchase a Trezor, which is a hardware wallet for those who are new to the crypto world. And I did a transaction of Bitcoin on Tuesday the 9th, and the transaction got confirmed on the 11th. Ooh! So that's not good, that's not good. So if we compare that with Ripple, for instance, Ripple can handle 70,000 transactions per 3.5 seconds. So they equal Visa now at the moment in terms of transactions. So that's 20,000 transactions per second, right? So we thought that NEM, for instance, was already good with the transactions. Yeah, they can do 3,000 up until 4,000 when Catapult will be released. But 20,000 transactions per second, right? So I wanted to end this video with a teaser of Shapeshift. So they are running this teaser campaign on a new product which they call Prism, and they are being very mysterious about it. But one thing is for sure, it is related to smart contracts. So what is it? So that's it for today. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.